Welcome. Thank you for your support and patronage. Please help us by subscribing to my YouTube channel, Engineer Ravenal De Jesus, ASEAN Engineer, PECE, LPT. And don't forget to like and share our videos. This is the URL of our channel, and these are some contents of our channel. About me, I was an electronics and communications engineer, garnered 5th highest place in the ECE licensure examination on April 2005. Under Republic Act 9292, all registered electronics and communications engineer would be registered as electronics engineer having the same initials or the ECE. A professional electronics engineer, PECE, advanced level engineer. ASEAN engineer, another advanced level engineer recognized in ASEAN member states. Licensed professional teacher, LPT, and a public servant. I also pass the career service professional examination given by the Civil Service Commission. We will really appreciate if you subscribe in our channel, as well as liking and sharing our videos. Rest assured, these videos will give information and entertainment for your reference and other purposes. Thank you very much. Hello everybody, welcome to the webinar of REC-IECEP-DICT entitled Elementary Fundamentals of Electronics and Electricity. This elementary is one of the prerequisites for you to obtain radio operator licenses such as amateur radio, radio telephone operator, and other licenses given by the National Telecommunications Commission or NTC. The objectives of this webinar are to equip participants / reviewees with knowledge, information, and skills relevant to radio communications, specifically principles of electronics / electricity. Involve participants to the discussion concerning radio communication practices. Course outline. Matter. Matter was already discussed since elementary science. Does this matter really matters in this webinar? Let's see. Again, free amateur radio orientation webinar. Fundamentals of amateur radio and preparation to NTC amateur radio class C examination. This amateur radio license is not limited to engineers and technicians. As a matter of fact, majority of intended participants here are teachers. Why? Because teachers opted to use radio communication to reach out their students, especially in remote community or areas limited by quarantine protocols. We salute them for their dedication and teaching. To continue, circuit components, Ohm's law and network theories, AC-DC or alternating current, direct current, frequency and wavelength, frequency spectrum. Okay, first part, matter and electricity. Of course, the classic definition, anything that occupies space or the volume and has mass, or the amount of matter. The amount of matter is mass, the space of the matter is volume. States of matter, solid, liquid, gas, and the other plasma known as the ionized gas. And matter
has its subdivision named element, substance that can be reduced to simpler substance. Examples: copper having the symbol of Cu, silicon, symbol is Si, and sulfur, symbol S. Copper, silicon, sulfur. Why these materials matter? Because the property of materials affect the electrical characteristic of that material or that substance. Let's see later. Compound, combination of two or more elements. Example, hydrochloric acid, or popularly known as the muriatic acid, it consists of hydrogen and chlorine. On the other hand, mixture, also combination, but not chemically combined. Example, the seawater. Water with salt, although salt also is a compound, salt and water is a form of physical mixture. As a matter of fact, you can separate it physically by heating them, distilling them, and so forth. On the other hand, alloy is also a mixture but associated with metals. Example, the solder. It consists of 40% lead, 60% tin. Although in Tagalog, the solder is called tinga. However, tinga is only 40% lead. I wonder why it is called tinga, considering that it has only 40% lead. Now, the molecule. Chemical combination of two or more atoms. In case of compounds, molecule is the smallest particle that has all properties of that compound. On the other hand, atom is known as the smallest part of an element, and this is one of the fundamental models of an atom. We have the hydrogen, we have the nucleus here consisting of protons, and the outer part is called electrons, and the neutrons. Again, what's inside the atom is the nucleus, while the outside portion of the atom are the electrons, or is electron in the case of hydrogen. In case of helium, two electrons, we have the nucleus here. Electron is negative charge, nucleus is positive charge. Simple. Fundamental. Elementary science. Next slide. Proton, PP, positive, located at the nucleus of the atom. On the other hand, electron, EEE, electron, negative. Located outside the nucleus. Electron is negative. Electrons revolve around the nucleus, similar to planetary model. Again, the planetary model of atom is a fundamental model. There are so many models in physics concerning the atom, but for the simplicity of the discussion here, we use the planetary model. Now, another particle, except for hydrogen, neutron is also located at the nucleus of an atom. Again, except for hydrogen. Neutron, neutral, zero charge, neutron. This is somewhat deceptive. Proton P, neutron N, but neutral. electron is the one negative instead of neutron, neutral. Okay, so this is easy to memorize. So again, this is the sample diagram of atomic model. Electron, again, negative charge. Although electron is small, it affects the electrical property of the atom. It's small but significant in the science of electronics. In electricity, electron has a vital role. By default, atom is neutral. The number of protons equal to the number of electrons. Neutral. Supposedly, it is neutral. The number of protons of an atom is called the atomic number. The sum of the number of protons and neutrons is called mass number. Since proton is approximately 1,837 times heavier than electron, the mass of the latter, the last mentioned electron is negligible. Again, even electron is very light, electron has a vital role in electricity. Take note of that. Now, to continue, the properties of material. We can categorize materials in terms of their conductivity. Conductivity is the ability to transfer electrons. We have the conductor, copper, locally known as tanso. Copper, we know that it conducts electricity and it is metal. We also have insulators such as sulfur. The rule of the thumb, most conductors are metals, but there are conductors which are not metals. What are those? What are those substances or materials that are conductors but not metals? Let's see. Electrical properties, and in between of the two, conductor, insulator, between them we have the semiconductor, the silicon. If you are familiar with the name Silicon Valley is a place where electronic equipment, electronic gadgets are manufactured. The Silicon Valley. Copper, sulfur, silicon, conductor, metal, insulator, non-metal, semiconductor, metal or non-metal? Well, in between, let's see. Going back to the atomic model, the planetary model, we have the shells. Well, this involves some sort of chemistry and physics. However, in fundamentals of electricity, it seems this is limited in this discussion, but we have to present how conduction works or the flow of electron works. The outer shell has the weakest attraction to the positive nucleus. This is the one prone to be dislodged. When this valence electron, the outermost shell, dislodged by a force, especially the voltage or the electromotive force, it will move. And the movement of electron is called the electric current. So the electric current or expressed in amperes later, we will see. Okay. Technically, conductors have 1 to 3 valence electrons. Copper has 1. So it is categorized under conductor. we have the letter designation, the K-L-M-N-O-P-Q, the shell. This is somewhat chemistry or physics. So, valence electron, the outermost shell of an atom. Examples. The noble inert gases such as neon, as we discussed, 1 to 3 valence electron, conductor. How about this? 8. In case of sulfur, 6. What do you think? Pure water is also insulator. Water insulator, let's see. Helium, 2 valence electron, but it is considered inert gas. Why? Because its shell is already filled. Exception to the rule, helium. All of these materials or elements or substances are called insulator. Okay, conductor, 1 to 3. Insulator, 5 to 8. Except for helium. Okay, I repeat. 1, 2, 3, valence electrons, conductor. 5, 6, 7, 8, valence electrons, insulator. How about 4? Silicon, 4 valence electron. Germanium, 4 valence electrons. Also, carbon has 4 valence electrons, but more likely, a resistor, which opposes the current flow. Popularly used semiconductor is silicon followed by germanium. Lead also have 4 valence electron but likely a metal. Again, what kind of rule is that? As we said, 1 to 3 valence electrons are metals, conductor, but lead is also a metal. Take note. It is governed by some rules in physics, which is out of this presentation. If you really want to pursue the mystery behind this, it is discussed in one of my published book, which is actually the reference of this presentation. Cases of carbon, lead, tin are discussed in separate topics. Let's see. Again, let's stick to the rule of the thumb. 1, 2, 3 valence electrons, conductor. 5, 6, 7, 8 valence electrons, insulator except for helium. 4 valence electron, semiconductor except for lead and carbon. Because lead is more likely a metal, while carbon more likely insulator. Actually, not insulator but resistor. It conducts some current and opposes some resistor. It resists. Some electrons flow but opposed. Again, cases of carbon, lead, and tin are discussed in separate topics. Okay. We have the guessing time. Gising time. Gising in Tagalog means to wake up if we feel sleepy in this webinar. Which of the following is a metal? Again, we already discussed oxygen. We all know by nature this is gas. Although there are liquid oxygen, but by under normal condition, oxygen is a gas. So strip is strip this oxygen. How about the remaining 3? Silicon Valley, electronics, semiconductor. Okay. 2 remaining. Carbon, resistor, resist. What's left? So lead, this is what we call elimination process for you to survive the examination. Okay, the answer is letter C. Which is the best conductor among the others? We said that pure water is insulator, although we know that when your hands are wet, you touch a live wire, you get electrocuted. Best, take note, best. Pure water means there's no electrolyte, there's no ions involved, and definitely helium is a gas. Best, you're asking for the best. Definitely, the option, all of the choices, is already eliminated because best, you're looking for the best. So the answer is letter C, urine, a liquid containing of many electrolytes, many ions, the urine. Letter C, which of the following is a compound? Silicon, it's an element, a fundamental substance. Sulfur, of course not. Definitely, when one of the choices is dropped, the option all of the choices is also dropped. So the answer is letter A, salt. Okay, this video presentation, you may post this video presentation, take a screenshot for you to browse again and again. Again, this is a free webinar initiated by Radio Engineer Circle, DICT, and ICEP. Which material opposes the flow of current? Opposes. Conductor, it allows the flow. Definitely, conductor, it allows the flow. Metal also allows the flow. Conductor, semiconductor, allows the current flow halfway, semiconducting. So the answer is insulator. Okay. Continue. Charge is the quantity of electricity expressed in coulomb, this is the unit. And the charge of a proton is positive, 1.6 times 10 to the negative 19 coulomb. On the other hand, electron has negative charge. Same charge with proton, 1.6 times 10 to the negative 19 coulomb, but negative. Neutron, so zero. The flow of electron is the electric current expressed in amperes. And this is 1 ampere. It represents flow of electrons. How many electrons? 6.28 times 10 to the 18 electrons flowing per second. Components, of course, the fundamental component, the power source, the cell or a battery, it gives direct current, and the alternator or oscillator. Alternator is the contraction of the word alternating current generator or simply generator. Alternating current. Resistor, resist, opposes the current, resist. We have the inductor, induct. Resistor, resist. Inductor, induct. Well, inductor, induce. Induces what? Induce voltage. Opposes the current. Take note, opposes the change in current. I repeat, inductor induces voltage that opposes change in current. Resistor opposes the current. On the other hand, resistor opposes the change in current. stores in the form of magnetic field, and the unit is what? Henry. On the other hand, we have the condenser or the capacitor. Most technicians or mechanic call capacitor as condenser. Inductor is the coil, the choke coil. It also opposes change, on the other hand, voltage. Both inductor, capacitor, both of them, what? Store. Both of them store energy. Inductor, magnetic field, capacitor, electric field. Henry, farad. Okay. Voltmeter, it measures voltage or electromotive force. The unit is volt. Or what popularly known as tester. However, the multimeter consists not only of voltmeter but as well as ohmmeter. As well as ammeter. Again, so ammeter measures current in ampere. Ampere meter, voltmeter measures the voltage. Ammeter measures ampere or current. So these are schematic diagrams of the component. So you may take a screenshot of this or watch this video again and again. Another components, carbon resistor. Again, despite of the fact that carbon has 4 valence electrons, supposedly a semiconductor, but it is more likely used as resistor. Again, if you're interested to the theory behind why carbon is more likely a resistor rather than a semiconductor despite of having 4 valence electron, you may notify me in my contact and or separate presentation will be uploaded in order to explain the reason behind that. Carbon resistors are commonly used, but wire-wound resistors are more precise. Carbon resistor has temperature coefficient. Once the temperature changes, the resistance value also changes. On the other hand, wire-wound resistor, it has precise. What is precise? Precise means every time you make reading, the reading will be the same again and again. For example, I have a 1-ohm resistor. For example only, I have a 1-ohm resistor. I read it using my meter or ohmmeter. Again and again, 10 times, it gives 1 ohm. That's what you call precise or precision. Again, carbon resistor, popular, commonly used, economical, or low price. However, what? Less precise compared with wire wound resistor. But take note, wire wound resistor, despite of being precise, expensive. As well as wire wound resistors have limited frequency range because of reactance. Later we'll discuss the reactance. What is that reactance? Again, different types of resistors. To those who are tech savvy, potentiometer is the one you turn clockwise, counterclockwise. Most of the dial in your radio, on other electronic gadget, it's the potentiometer. Rheostat is also a dial. What's the difference of those? Potentiometer, potential. It varies what? This varies the potentiometer, potential difference. Voltage is the one varied by potentiometer. On the other hand, the rheostat, it is also a dial. It varies what? Of course, it varies the current. Okay, both of them are variable resistors. Again, potentiometer, variable resistor, rheostat, variable resistor. Potentiometer is a variable resistor that varies the voltage. Rheostat is a variable resistor that varies the flow of current. Now, in measurement, we have these SI prefixes. You're already familiar with this, even the market. In the marketplace, you encounter the kilo. In the road, you encounter the kilo, kilometer, kilogram. You encounter that. The mega, giga, the tera, when you're measuring the data, you're familiar with that. You may memorize this. This is not hard to memorize because you encounter this in our daily lives. These are the SI base unit. Again, there's no harm in memorizing because most of them are encountered in our daily lives. Second, the meter, the kilogram. Well, except for Kelvin, mole, candela. I think these are encountered in, probably in lab, in research. But rarely on marketplace. Kilogram, you can encounter it in the marketplace. These are the assignment of color coding of carbon resistor. These are the table. Somewhat tedious, but we suggest you memorize this. This is not hard to memorize because it has mnemonic. These are the mnemonic, but however, warning, caution, this page may contain offensive for some readers. Just a reminder, these are the mnemonics for you to help you memorize the order as well as the table mentioned in the previous slide. But again, some sort of reminder, this may seem offensive to other readers, so discretion is advised. Okay, some have exercises. If you refer to the table mentioned in the previous slide, supposedly you have taken the screenshot. What's the value of this resistor? Blue, the first digit. Second digit is red, so you have already have the idea. The first significant digit, the second significant digit, the multiplier, and here, the tolerance. So what's the value? Referring to the table mentioned in the previous slide. That's the reason why I advise you to take the screenshot. So the answer is, okay, 62 ohms plus minus 5% tolerance. Okay, that's the value. Now, as we mentioned, the 25,000 ohms is somewhat long to write. We can use the SI prefix. So 25 kilo ohms rather than say 25,000 ohms. That's how the SI units help us. Even in the marketplace, it is very difficult to say, I'm going to buy 1,000 grams of fish. Instead, we say 1 kilogram of fish or 1 kilo. Ate, 1 kilong isda. Rather than 1,000, 1,000 gramo. 1,000 gramo ng isda. Okay, so somewhat ridiculous. somewhat satirical for us to keep us awake in this webinar. Another component is the capacitor. So, capacitance, the property to store electrical energy. On the other hand, inductor can also store capacitor, inductor, both of them store. So, these are some features of capacitor or condenser. These are the sample problem. So, since this sample problem are already solved, again, you may take the screenshot of this for you to further study how the problems are solved with the given formula. Supplementary problems. So many supplementary problems. We cannot discuss the whole thing in 3 hours because a network theory is a one semester subject. The semiconductor physics, another one semester subject. Circuit analysis, another one semester subject. So, it seems it's up to you to explore the rest of this supplementary problem with a step-by-step solution. Another component, inductor. Again, inductor, store electrical energy in the form of magnetic field. The symbol of inductance is L, the unit is Henry. Okay, you can see the inductor in the choke, or literally, technicians, mechanic called inductor as choke. And you can see it in the transformer. Simply, inductor is a coil. Inductance in series. So, schematic diagram of the inductor. And these are sample pictures of inductor. The one portion or the one coil of a transformer is actually inductor. Additional components, schematic symbols of these components. Now, the popular Ohm's law. This is how it works. When I tap this letter I, what can you see? When I tap letter I, you can see what? You can see again. Here is the formula. When I push the button letter I, what you see? E over R. Also, when I push button R, what you see? E over I. R equal to E over I. Yan po. Okay. When I push the button letter E, what you see? When you push button E, you see I adjacent with R. Okay. And what is that operation? E equal to I adjacent with R. What operation? Multiplication. And this is the reference. If you want to read this book, well, we will appreciate if you read this book, because the discussion behind the materials, the properties of materials, as well as the derivation of this formula are discussed in this book. Now, why Ohm's law is so popular nowadays? Before, Ohm's law was rejected because it was simple, but people believe that a wire, a metal wire, or simply a wire, it conducts electricity. And people believe that conductors are all the same. However, George Simon Ohm conceptualized that the conductivity of various wires are different. They have different level of conduction. And that's what you call resistor. Take note. This is the pipe. This is the narrow pipe. A wide pipe, a narrow pipe. What will happen? In a narrow pipe, electrons will have friction. It will generate heat. And take note. Look at these zigzag lines. The random movement of electrons produces what? The zigzag line. The schematic symbol for what? Resistor. The zigzag line or the randomness of the movement of electrons. In Tagalog, we call it sargo. When you hit bigger balls, the random movement generated or the sargo. Okay, we have already discussed this. Tap the desired sector. Now, find the current flowing through a 6 ohm resistor supplied by 12 volts. The formula, okay. I equal to E over R. So that's division. Okay. Find the voltage across. Voltage. Tap the letter E. You get multiplication. You get the multiplication IR. Solution. Another guessing time, stay awake. Conventional flow assumes the current flow from blank terminal of the battery. Conventional, the current flow from, most people think that current flowing from positive to negative. That's what you call conventional flow. What people believe? Conventional. The answer is letter A. On the other hand, we have the electron flow. The electron flow is that the movement is negative, from negative to positive, letter B. Now, again, Ohm's law. I just give the answer, not the solution anymore. I already discussed the formula. It's letter B. Continue Ohm's law. Again, problem, solution, answer. Formula, solution, answer. Okay, I'll pause a while. Take the screenshot, copy, or whatsoever. Next slide. Problem, solution, answer. Problem, solution, answer. You arrive on the same answer despite of many formulas using Ohm's law together with the derived Joule's law. You may refer to the previous slide regarding the formula. What we discuss here is how you use the button. Push some button, you will get some derivation. Continuing the Ohm's law, we have the series circuit. The total resistance is actually the sum of all resistors given in that series circuit. Series circuit, the current flow through its components are the same. It's the same. The power dissipated, on the other hand, is actually the sum of all power consumed by its component, dissipated or delivered by the source and dissipated by the load. Again, the current flowing through a series circuit is identical or the same for each component. That's the highlight of series circuit. Take note of this. I put asterisk here. Take note of this. All of the parameters, resistance, voltage, and power are all additive, while current is identical or the same in series circuit. Example. The total resistance, 1 plus 2 plus 3, 6. The current is 2 amperes. So the voltage drop per component. Here. What is QED? QED is an acronym, Latin, quod erat demonstratum, or I already demonstrated, or I already showed the solution, something like that. So here, sample problem for series circuit. The power dissipated, on the other hand, is the sum of individual component. On the other hand, Ohm's law, again, in parallel circuit, voltage drop across the parallel are the same. That's the reason why in the household, we use the parallel circuit. The voltage drop across appliances are the same, but different current rating. The total current is additive or the sum of each component. The power dissipated is still the sum of each component. And the voltage drop same for each component. By the way, the total resistance has different formula. It is the reciprocal of the sum of the reciprocal. Let's see. The total resistance is 1 ohm. How? R1 is 2. So we have, we take the reciprocal of 2. So we have 1 over 2. Take the reciprocal of 3 ohms. We have 1 over 3. Take the reciprocal of 6. We have 1 over 6. Okay. You add up all of them. You add them all and take the reciprocal, and that will be the total resistance. Again, the rule of the thumb is this: the total sum of parallel resistance is always less than to the lowest value. The lowest value in this circuit is 2, so the answer is less than 2, 1 ohm. That's the trick. So these are the individual currents or the branch current here. And the total current. Now, we have the open or the closed circuit. This is an advanced network theory. And seems, again, 3 hours of webinar seems not enough to discuss the entire network theory and to provide supplementary problems in this webinar. Of course, this is a pre-recorded webinar. In the webinar proper, we have the opening ceremony, opening remarks, message from the officials, and the Q&A portion. That's the reason why this pre-recorded presentation is not exactly 3 hours, of course. This is for presentation purposes. And once this presentation is through, we will be open for Q&A portion. Before this pandemic, we have the face-to-face discussion. We have the board, either blackboard or whiteboard. We present the diagram. We present the solution step by step. However, it seems difficult to conduct in this virtual webinar or virtual seminar through webinar. But we will do our best to help you. And we will try to provide separate session for the discussion, especially sample circuit problems if you have difficulties in determining such. To continue, when you have the open circuit, you have zero current. Of course, how the current flow if the circuit is open? The voltage is unknown and it has a high value resistance or the infinite resistance. The Thevenin's theorem is a network theorem, which is limited in this webinar. Again, as I have said before, we may offer separate session for these electrical network theories. There are so many of them. But as we discussed, the syllabus covered here is fundamental. Again, continue. If we have the short, we have the unknown current and it has zero resistance. Again, open circuit, when you open the circuit, definitely the current will not flow because it is open. So that's governed by what? By Ohm's law. The current flows to a closed path. But it is open. So, open means zero current. A short circuit, you have a current but unknown. So, take note of that. Okay. Another guessing time to keep you awake. Guessing. Up because it's kind of sleepy in listening in this webinar because of the time constraints we encountered. Supposedly in weekends we are supposed to have a quality time with our family, but we are listening in this webinar in which interaction is minimized as compared with the face-to-face discussion. Okay, which is true for both series and parallel circuits. It's true. Resistance is additive. Well, in series, yes, but not in parallel. Voltage is additive. In series, yes, but not in parallel. Current is additive. In parallel circuit, Yes, but not in series. So only one choice is left. Power is additive. So the answer is letter D. Whatever resistors are connected, whether series or parallel, the power dissipated, the total power dissipated by the network is actually the sum regardless of how it is connected, whether series or parallel combination of resistors. Now, two resistors are connected in shunt or parallel. The total resistance is letter A, higher than the lower resistor. Letter B, higher than the higher resistor. Letter C, lower than the lower resistor. Letter D, all of the above are correct. Okay. All of the above correct. All of the choices correct. This is some tip for intelligent guessing. When you see all of the above, all of the choices, look in the three remaining choices. Higher than higher, lower than lower, contradicting. When you say all of the above correct, all of the choices correct, the choices you are referring with should not contradict. Higher than higher contradict with lower than lower. And higher than higher is actually additive in nature. And additive resistance network is applicable on series network or series combination of resistors. And what's the rationale behind a parallel circuit? Suppose that you have a road or a lane. When you add additional lanes, the congestion or the traffic minimizes. The congestion lessens. The flow becomes faster. Same case with the parallel network of resistors. You add additional lane means the total resistance is lower than the lower. The answer is letter C. The parallel network of resistor is analogous to a road with additional lanes open. Two equal value resistors are connected in series. Reconnecting the two resistors in parallel may dissipate blank power as compared with the series network. Okay, the derivation behind this is somewhat long, but the answer is letter B. Why? Well, it seems it is necessary to create another presentation to show the solution behind of these theories. Now, let's now proceed to alternating current. Alternating current. Again, in direct current, the voltage or the source have the same amplitude or height or amount from time to time. When you say this is 12 volts, assuming this is 12 volts, for a long period of time, it is the same as 12 volts. But on alternating current, assuming this is 12 volts, assuming this is 12 volts peak, what will happen? The amplitude or the height, what? Changes. The amplitude or the height changes time after time. Sometimes zero, sometimes negative. And it will become positive again, down again. Take note, the peak of the AC will not deliver the same heating effect or energy or power with the peak DC. What do I mean? This 12 volt peak is not equivalent to the 12 volt peak of the DC. We use instead what? The root mean square value or the RMS, and this is the formula. Thus, the 1 volt RMS have the same heating effect with the 1 volt DC for a given known resistor. I repeat, the 1 volt RMS have the same heating effect or the energy effect or the power effect as compared with the 1 volt DC source used in a known resistor. Okay, to simplify this, you have your 220 volts in your home, in your outlet. You have a 220 volt AC. The 220 volts indicated there is actually what? This is actually RMS, the root mean square value, the effective value. The RMS, the root mean square value. The peak value of your AC outlet is around 311 volts. There's a formula that will compute the peak value there. The value you see labeled as 220 volts is actually the RMS or the root mean square value of the AC. Example of DC. Of course, the battery, AC, alternator, and oscillators. Again, alternator or the alternating current generator. So, this is how the AC works. You have the positive peak. You have the negative peak. Resembling a sine wave or sinusoidal wave. The rule of the thumb. So, this is how the voltage induced in the magnetic field, normal perpendicular. So the frequency is the number of cycles per second expressed in hertz. The period, the time required for one cycle to be completed. The wavelength is the length of the wave for a given cycle, already we presented in this diagram. Okay, resistance is the opposition to the current. Reactance is also opposition to the current. Impedance is also opposition to the current. So, what are the difference of those three? In direct current, you use resistance, opposition to the current. But resistance, reactance, impedance, all are opposition to the current. Resistance, it dissipates or consumes the power, the true or the real power. We have the reactance. It stores the power or the energy. You call reactive power. And impedance or the total opposition resultant applied to the power. This has a formula known as the power triangle. Again, this is limited in this presentation as we are discussing the fundamentals of electricity. Okay, to make the story short, direct current sees only resistance. On the other hand, AC, it sees alternating current, it sees impedance. We have a special phenomenon in AC circuit called resonance. Okay, voltage in series circuit, additive. Current in parallel circuit, additive. Okay, when you refer to the fundamental theory in DC. Again, the resonance occurs in what? Resonance occurs in AC. Resonance. The capacitive reactance is equal to inductive reactance. Now, These are some table of the electromagnetic spectrum. There's a pattern or technique how to memorize, to fill up this table, and hopefully in the next presentation this will be discussed. Now, the voice frequency, the voice you are hearing from me, the voice hearing from other people, it has a range of 300 to 3000 hertz. And the audio range that a human can hear is around 20 to 20,000 hertz depending on your sensitivity. So the medium frequency, example, AM radio, the high frequency or the short wave. And you have the VHF, the commercial TV station, the TV channel 2 to 13, the UHF, so the channel 13 onwards. Okay, again, the frequency, review, the period, period, the time, frequency is the number of cycles, how frequent it vibrates or oscillates, the number of cycles per second, the period, the time required to complete one cycle, and the wavelength, the distance. Okay. Another guessing time. Blank is the science dealing with the development and application of devices and systems involving flow of electrons. Science, electrons. Again, keyword, the science dealing with electrons. So the answer is electronics. Now, another set of guessing time. The basic unit of electric power. This is what? Ohm is resistance. This is what? This is what? Resistance. So, no. Volt is the electromotive force or the voltage. No. Ampere, that's the electric current or the intensity of the flow. So, the power is what? What? The answer is letter B. Electrical power or what? What term used to express the amount of electrical energy? Take note, energy. 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 This is power. This is electromotive force. Coulomb, this is charge. We are talking with energy. So the answer is letter A, joules. Device used to store electric energy. Battery will store, but battery, take note, battery store energy chemical. In the form of chemical, stored chemical potential energy. It store energy, but in the form of chemical means. Electrostatic field, take note, electrostatic field. Inductor also stores energy, but magnetic field. Definitely, inductor transformer, they are same principle of operation. I mean, the manner they store the energy. So, the answer is letter C. That's capacitor. Letter C. The answer is letter C. Not highlighted. Capacitor. The answer is C. The power associated with inductor and capacitor. Again, resistance, resist. Reactance, react. React, react. The answer is reactive power, letter D. So the answer is letter D. Again, letter C is the answer for number 3. Store energy. Electric field, electrostatic field capacitor. Inductor, store energy but magnetic field or in the form of magnetic field. Power associated with inductors and capacitors, reactance, reactive power. The answer is D. Okay, so references sources were provided in the full version. Thank you very much. References.